Okay, one of the suggestions for punishment stress test on that sample board was firing a 0.22 air rifle pellet at it, but I don't have 0.22, I've got 0.20 and 177, so this is 0.20. And just as a comparison, we've got two targets sat there downrange, exactly 10 metres away, with 11.2 foot-pound muzzle energy at this air rifle, yep. We've got a baked bean can full of water and the fibreglass sample board. So we'll do the baked bean can first. That's going to be absolute devastation on that can. I'll show it you in a second. Now I've got the sample board of fibreglass almost in a vertical position. So once I've shot that, I'll go sort of towards the top right hand corner. Once I've shot at that, I'll show you the frontal damage on the top coat and the fracture damage what will be on the back, because I don't think it's going to pass through it. Oh, yeah. Right, let's go and get the targets. I can see through the scope what it's done. It's chipped off the top coat at bare minimum. Possibly gone through it, but I don't think it would. But there again, 10 metres away with this much energy. It could have gone through. So let's go and have a look, and I'll show you the can first and then the fibreglass sample. Right, this is quite interesting. I knew this would happen. That's it, but it was full of water. So that's your entry point. So it penetrated however thick that aluminium is, went through the water and came down at an angle. I'm not shooting at such a steep angle. I'm not shooting down like that. It's slightly down, but the pellet has gone in, deflected in the water, and then still had enough energy to make that exit wound on the way out. Now this is more interesting to me, what it did to the fibreglass. See, not only has it chipped the top coat off, but it's also gone through it. These are the fractures from the stab marks with the knife. And that's the exit wound. So entrance, where that big chip is there. And the exit wound has taken all them fibres with it. It's pretty devastating, isn't it? Now the question in my mind is, A, how long would I need to leave this to cure fully before it became strong enough to withstand that energy concentrated in such a small surface area there, yeah? Would that even happen at all, being this thin? That's only like 1.5 mil. How thick would I need to step that fibreglass up to before it couldn't do that kind of damage and it did actually bounce off? Interesting. Want to show that to a customer? Oh, what happened to it there, Matt? Yeah, I shot it with an air rifle. Pete, you're asking about doing a stressing it to the point where it did fracture, and have a look at the lines on it. So that's how much it's been bent over, and look under the microscope. That is every bit of strength I have got to be able to bend that. No fracturing in that. If there is, it's very slight. Let's try it the other way. Crikey, you can almost roll it up like a newspaper. No, it's not. I think there will be a point. I'd literally have to stand on it to get it to fracture, which I don't want to do because this is actually useful to me to show to people. So yeah, there's the air rifle stress test. Got another little project I could do with these idle hands of mine. My daughter's just moved out, so she found this in the house and she threw it in the skip. And I'm like, that's perfectly usable. You don't throw good things away like that, being the magpie that I am. So what can I use that for? I've already used it as a floor protection tray. Mix up some resin on that. I could make one of those resin tables out of it. Use this as the mould. Put some inserts in for legs. Take it out of that mould and boom, got myself a resin table. Polish it all up. I've got no need for a table, but if I was going to do it, I'd use polyester resin as opposed to epoxy, just to show you the difference between that super clear stuff they use on tables. Or I could just literally use it as a mould to turn out another couple of these, you know, replicate this exactly, to use as floor protection, mixing up stations for work, somewhere to put my boots when I come in the house. And get a video out of it to show you the process of how to use that as a mould to make something, you know, useful. Possibly put a core material in it, because I know for an absolute fact, yeah, if I'd have put a core mat between layers of fibreglass, yeah, that pellet would not have gone through it. It becomes too thick and too strong with a core material in it. So, endless possibilities with fibreglass, I suppose. Hopefully, if this weather stays as it is, relatively warm, above my minimum preferred working temperature, and not raining, maybe I'll get another job done towards the end of the week. Friday and Saturday looking more favourable than any days. It might save the customer building a big, I say big, you'll see it on Friday if I do the job, stroke Saturday. So yeah, there's your air rifle test. That's about it, really. Cheers.